pray for your blessings on the life of the celebrant. Give her many more fruitful years to come in Jesus' name. In the name of the Father, Son, Spirit. Amen.
We're supposed to have about 5 minutes for time to mingle. But with the look of things, I think we just use about 3 minutes for that.
What is this magic?
Mama.
I need that
Mama.
Magic.
All the clothes you dey wear, you be chassis. This your catwalk, be like you dey practice. You be too sad, you be ruthless.
Hey.
I be triple, oh. And now you be too fresh.
Makata, makata, malele.
Makata, makata,
makata,
makata, makata,
makalele. I say makata, makata, malele.
I'd like us to please give a whooping round of applause to bring that here. Thank you.
Hello. I guess I should say, hey, Cabo. Boboy. Inumi dungong. Lati ri boboy inibibai. Today is my birthday, and I wanted to celebrate with a lot of people that have influenced my experience here. And so that's what we're going to be doing here today. So I'm going to be leaving soon, but I wanted to tell you all how important you are to me and just to welcome you all here. So I invited you all for a reason, and that's because you've made my experience here in Ibadan very, very special. It's something that I won't forget. I've had a lot of cultural and spiritual edification because of the conversations, because of the ideas that I've shared, because of the laughs that I've shared, the hardships, the complaints that I shared with all of you. So I just want to say thank you, and I want to welcome you. And of course, for people who don't know, now, make I clear something up for you. I am not Chinese. I am not Lebanese. I'm not Indian or French or many of the other things that people mistake me for. I'm African American, but I am Nigerian by blood. So, of course, you know, with African American history, many of us left West African countries, our ancestors anyways, and when they got to the US, they all mixed together and they created African American culture. So in my blood, when I did my DNA test, I have Ghana, Mali, Senegal, I have Congo, Benin, Togo, South Africa. I have a lot of different blood in me from West African countries. So it's 85% African, 65% Nigerian. So that means that the most of me is Nigeria. 35 from the East, 30 from the West. Out of the 65%, 35 is from the East, 30 from the West. Oruko mamami ni Adama. Mama mamami fu mamami oruko na. Chubon mama mamami wono mon kom rara nipa orile Nigeria nipa asha ibo. But that name still came down to my mother, who was the firstborn daughter. You know, so the name also fit the circumstances of her birth. So it's just in our blood. And the way that that got handed down, there was no other reason. My grandmother didn't know anything about Africa. She didn't study Africa. She didn't know anything about Igbo culture, but many Igbo people went to the Deep South in slavery. And my grandmother was from the Deep South in the U.S. So we still carry that blood in us. That African blood is still in us. And there's a lot of cultural, you know, relevance that we have to Africa and to African traditions. And one of those traditions is singing. So my ancestors, in order to survive that Middle Passage crossing, you know, where they were taken from these West African countries and sold into slavery in the US, that was a 3-month trip across the Atlantic in the belly of a ship chained down to other people, dead or alive. And so they suffered. And one thing that they used to get them over was the power of their song. And so, do you know this song? Amazing Grace. So that song was actually written by a white slave ship captain. And the tune of that song, that was the warning song of all of these West African, these different West African warning songs coming from the enslaved Africans that were in the belly of the ship. So when they got to the U.S., they created what we call over there Negro spiritual. So they called on God through song. The songs that is very common, that's sung commonly in our churches, is what God has done for us. So I wanted to share a little bit of that song. Down through the years, came back thing. We didn't have instruments. They stripped us all of our instruments, you know, every possession that we had before we got to the U.S. because they knew that you could talk with the drum. You could send messages with the drum. So they didn't allow you to take any instruments. All we had was our hands and our feet. Down through the years, the Lord do to me. Hallelujah. Down through the years, the Lord did good to me. Trying to tell you, down through the years, oh, the Lord did good to me. Trying to tell. Sing that song when I'm doing my devotions in the morning because it's so true. God has been good to me. With all of you, all of the ways that you have influenced my life, all of the ways that you have changed my path, it has really been good to me. And even when I think about leaving, I get misty. But I can't mess up this snatchiness. So, but I would like to just offer those things and just share a piece of myself and my culture with you because you shared so much of yourselves and your culture with me. And I would like to say welcome and thank you. And the last thing I'll say is that we need to stay together. We need to stay together. Not just me and you, but Africans, African Americans, people in the African diaspora, people in the continent of Africa, we all need to stay together, you know? Because I would like to think, I don't know, but I would like to think that I've influenced some people or someone here, and I know that you've all influenced me in some way. Whether you call me Oyibo Pepe, or Oni Jagidi Jagum, or something, you've all influenced me. So I'd like to just leave you with this. I'm so in love with you. Whatever you want to do is all right with me. 'Cause you make me feel so brand new.
To be here to honor someone who has honored me in terms of knowledge and inspiration. Please, you would bear with us, the team that put up this documentary. It took us less than a week to come up with it. Making this documentary has been a great journey for me, learning about the person or mixed. I think it's been more defined than what I've done before. It's been, okay, let me not take you into the documentary. I think you should witness it yourself. The first cut was 2 hours, but I had to cut it down to 10 minutes.
Is told me that as you were recording her, Kemi.
The time I was not feeling too well, she insisted on following me to the hospital. That was a very, very touching move to me.
Well, Maria, my friend, she's a gentle tiger.
Since I've been working with her, she has been a good woman. I like her and she has been doing well. And she's accommodating and all that.
You really mean so much to us and you've done so much for us. So you deserve nothing than the best.
Please, a round of applause for her. Thank you so, so much. Yeah, so the first game, Who Knows Maria Best? That's the title of the game. I think we'll be asking based on the documentary. Okay, so the gift for the first... so once you meet, it's not my chef, Josh. That's our friend that talked. He's really going to come there. Question number one. Where is Maria from? That's question number one. Better than right. It's an exchange. And what's her grandmother's name? Grandmother's Igbo name. Her mom's Igbo name. So which university did Dr. Maria attend? That was from the documentary too. We are getting that from the documentary. Which university did Dr. Maria attend? Which one describes her the most? From the documentary, not from what you think of her. Which word describes Dr. Maria the most?
Who even on her? I got yes. So, art?
Yes.
Art, you got the chain, Art. You got it right?
What are your Yoruba name?
So, when I first came, or before, when I was studying Yoruba in my university in the US, they gave me Teen Wola. So, I don't really use that all the time. I use Oluwakemi.
Let's say Oluwakemi so that everybody will get zero for now. I don't want them to get our scores easily. Okay, Kemi, if the K is small letter, it is wrong. The K has to be capital letter. Yes. The K has to be capital letter. Because she has agreed that she needs Oluwa in front. Number three, what's her mom's name?
It's Ada May. But it's Adama in Igbo.
She finished from? That I answer. If you miss the spelling, you are wrong. In the university, the verb if R is not there, it's wrong. Since S is not C.
So it's. I went to Michigan State University. Michigan State. They're two different schools. Hey, you can't call Michigan State, and you can't call Spartans. Yeah, you can't call the Spartans like they're from U of M. The Wolverines are U of M. Spartans are Michigan State. You cannot do that.
University of Michigan, zero. States.
Michigan State.
Go ahead, thank you. Michigan State University. Wow! Only that leader, mom. Ah, it's wrong. Only. Actually, I know you're bad, Yancy. And it's only. If I say that leader, I'm talking about a behavior. But only that, which means it's you. Science. Oh, yeah. Mark it. Oh, yeah, yeah. Very. Start to mark. One. Over five. And no more. Dr. Maria, nobody can get 5 here. Just two.
Difference by
we are right. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Oh, she's trying to chose the win now. But I, in a wish, we are pleased. let's appreciate him. You want. So you have just a with Chef John. So now we go to testimonials.
Good evening, everybody. I don't have much to say, but I want to say she's just an amazing person. First day she came to my office, she was totally different from every other person I've met. And I don't know her. And then she said, "Can I have a picture with you?" And I was like, I wasn't sure she was talking to me. I just said that she should go ahead and take the picture she wants to take in my office. But she insisted she wanted to have a picture with me, and that was the first encounter. But since then, she's just been an amazing person.
The first time I met her and the first few encounters was not very interesting because she was always giving me lots of assignments. I'm a student and mentee. She's always giving me lots of assignments, lots of workloads to do, and I was always getting angry every day. So, but with time, we got really close. She really wanted to bring the best out of everyone in our class. She really wanted to see you do the best. She always devotes her time to each and every student, which is actually very uncommon, and I respect and appreciate that about her. She has grown from being my lecturer to my mentor and then to my friend. I appreciate you sincerely, and I say happy birthday to you.
She's a very interesting person, wonderful person. She sang on many occasions, and she knows what she wants. You know, she's someone that has a direction and will give it all it takes to actually get to attain a goal. And like the name everybody has been calling her, Onicha Gizitagon, I think I've known that right from the very first day. I think that name wouldn't leave her, even in America.
Dr. Maria Martins, she's a wonderful person. Let me start by saying that the first time I saw Dr. Martins was in a seminar series, one presented by Dr. Sharon Omotosho on hairlessness and listen. And her contribution was very splendid. But most importantly, something caught my attention during the documentary. It goes a long way to portray her as someone very humble. Because I never knew she was an associate professor, and yet she's very humble. In this part of the world, if you're a professor or you're a reader and you want to address me, the professor must come first before my name. So we wish her well in her endeavors. She's someone I used to run into almost on a daily basis in African studies. I never knew she had such a pedigree about her. So doctor, congratulations, happy birthday, and wish you farewell back to the United States. Thank you very much.
Remember, there was a day she asked me, what exactly do your classmates want? I'm not close to her, I'm not a friend, but she gave listening ears, even though she knows what she exactly was going to do, but she was still listening to what you have to say. And at the end, she was just, I like the fact that she takes her time to read her work one after the other. And correct you. That's what I love about when she read that proposal, she took her time to complete and correct you. And also, like, the aspect of what I love is doing that proposal. You know, every seminar proposal, when it's ready, lecturers are going to, you know, talk to you and all that. But she presented her point in a way that you won't feel less of yourself. You will believe you did something. And I saw my class in looking forward to have Dr. Maria in the hall to, you know, just come and say something about my work. Even if I did rubbish, just come and say something. I want to wish you a long life and prosperity, ma'am. Thank you for investing in us, and I wish you all the best. God bless you.
Thank you. Sorry, I'll be like, it relates to that bar. And when I actually got to know that she's a doctor, I didn't even know she's an assistant professor. I'm like, doctor. Can you take my PhD? My cry. Only just your own shape, man. You know? And it's the way she relates. I believe she relates to people that you won't even know that she is a doctor. No, you would not believe me. Like normal Nigerian lecturers. You want to call his name, but you forgot to put doctor in front, or you are in trouble.
Yes, please. Oh, that wasn't me. So, really, Dr. Maria is just awesome like that.
all white, come with their hair, they want to make the hair look different. But she was trying to make the hair look natural. One of our first talks was, Maria, how low she is anyway. And then she actually was that one. I think she's a very, Maria could be conservative. I don't want to say what everybody has said. Maria could be very conservative. She picks her words. At this age of ours, she's an assistant professor. You can imagine how much she would have been very diligent in her work. Even though now she's mentioned on the on Paul Foundation, then she's quite a renowned researcher.
And being the only guy in the department or in the unit, it wasn't really funny. But with her presence, she really made a lot out of me, especially when it comes to meeting up with assignments and the time submission and the time allotted for the submission of your work. And there's one thing she keeps saying that really keeps me going. That moment when she tells you, one thing I like about you is that you are very courageous and you just want to say what you have, not minding what or who is there to see what you are doing.
And she just walk into the church like one gangster like that. I'll sit down and do like this. I'll just be looking at that from one side like, kick on it, God. You know, that stupid Nigerian thing that will just well up inside and be like, kick on, no shame, be gone. But the day I got wild was actually because of her hair too.
Happy birthday to Maria. Beautiful, elegant Maria. Just like MC said just now, she has been so stylish. I admire most of her styles, most especially the hair. Hairdo has been so creative of you to have that one most of the time and to maintain your hair that way. Kudos to you. One thing I like about her that got me connected to her was the aspect of the culture, how she integrated into the Yoruba culture. To see someone like her speak Yoruba so fluently, much more than some of this is not slight anymore, much more than some of our Igbo brothers or even Hausa brothers. Just that each one she was here and she has learned a lot about the culture. Even to the aspect of the respect part of it. Yeah. She knows that quite well. She knows when to be there, she knows when to be cool. Kudos to you. I appreciate that so much about you. And much more also that I wouldn't want to talk about that topic now. We are integrating, connecting culturally because I'm into cultural studies too. And we've been doing some things together.
An average person from US is trained to be bold, to have this high level of self-esteem. Now, such that if care is not taken elsewhere, some other climbs might be taken as pride. See, well, I don't know Maria's experience so far, so good here, but I have not seen her relating to us in that same understanding. She's able to flow with us despite any experiences I've seen. I want to appreciate the fact that she understands our culture and she doesn't look down on Nigerians. So kudos to you. Thank you very much.
Was on the road.
Maria Kajo, Maria gone rock in Kaifele Yaze. Who feel that she don't dance? So, game two. Whoever wants to dance, raise your hand now. Yeah, the prize. Woo! Okay, the prize is tickets to Ventura for two. Which means you will win one person, the winner. Don't you shall do it.
Thank you. me on your point.
Happy birthday to you.
friends.
So I would like to thank everybody for coming out to the party. Actually, this is my first birthday party. Like, I've never had a birthday party. So I wanted to do something special. I wanted to surround myself with people that, you know, have influenced me, that have hopefully also been influenced by me, and, you know, that has made my stay here such a loving and, you know, exciting and, you know, varied experience. So I'd like to thank you again. I'd like to thank all of the people who helped me to put this together. You know, the decorators, you know, because I gave them Wahala Didi Gong. You, Michael, yes. You see, his arm is in a sling because I broke it, though. I broke that. So I'd like to thank them. I'd like to thank the MC. She did a wonderful job. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. I'd like to thank everybody who came from my church, all of my students, everybody who, you know, wished me well, everybody who had something nice to say. I'm glad that nobody said anything jaggedy jaggedy today. Yeah, so who else? Oh, I'd like to thank Ms. Gia, Taiwo Gia. She helped me out a lot to put everything together. I'd like to thank my goons, my bodyguards that stood here, you know, very fiercely with their body paints. They look so nice, and they did such a good job. So thank you so much. I've been telling people that they shouldn't be afraid to come to Nigeria. They shouldn't be afraid to come to Africa. And it's because I've experienced so much love and appreciation, and I do love and respect that culture of appreciation, of respect, of care, of communalism and humanity, recognizing the humanity and other people that you have here. So thank you so much for edifying my life and for teaching me so many valuable things that I'll always carry with me. Thank you very much. Okay, I forgot some very special people, the dancers. So they're all here. So I'd like to thank every one of them for coming out, for rehearsing, for carrying the drum, for doing everything you've done. Thank you very much.
What is this magic?
Mama.
I need that
Mama.
Magic.
Body clutch you dey wear, you be chassis. This your catwalk, be like you dey practice. You be too set, you be ruthless. I dey triple, nana you be too fresh. All the moves you dey bust, na chana. Na wahala you dey cause, na yawa. Disgusting, you be stinking. You got a bad guy singing. Baby do me jelly. I beg you do me jelly. Baby do me jelly. I beg you to me, jelly. Baby, let me be your customer. Give me everything plus Jara. Say she want to give me gradually. You should give me all I could buy. Baby, do me jelly. I beg you to me, jelly. Yeah, come baby, take it easy on the bad guy. Put it down like you're looking for the last prize. Back it up, then put it on me. Make I play guitar while you singing on key. She said she want to serve it on a good plate. I then sprinkle salt and hot spice. But waiting how they do, where I know wait. You the kind of babe where I gas wife. All the clothes you they wear, it be chassis. This your car talk, be like you the practice. You be two sets, you be rude.